I'm Adam, and today I'm going to show you how to install false colors on the GH5. You need VLOG to be able to install LUTs on your camera, but if you have that, then this shouldn't be any kind of problem. You might already know how to kind of do this once you have the file you need, but let's get to it. So first things I'm going to show you is the way I did it, and then a second way, which I like the other way someone else did it. I think it was, Benjamin, the way he showed me an example of, and I really like that one more than the one that I am about to show you, but I'll show you both. So first things first, I'm going to go to LUT Calc, and I'll include a link in the description. So you want to come down here to LUT Analysis. I'm going to go to the LUT that Panasonic gives you for VLOG. Go with the cube version. You're going to hit open. And analyze. Then you're going to come up to what camera you're using. So obviously, you don't have the GH5 in here, but GH4 is going to be the closest thing you got. Make sure all this is correct, Panasonic VLOG, V-Gamut, and these are going to be what the 709 profile that they give you. Name this whatever you want. I think it has to be under 8 characters. I can't remember off the top of my head, but name it whatever you want. So I'll just call mine False C. Then we're going to make sure we click on Camera and go down to Varicam, because that's what we're using this for, is a monitoring LUT. And so, yep, that changes it over here, so make sure you come back over here, go back to Panasonic. Yep, and that's good there. Make sure we have false color selected. You can click there as well. Hit this preview, and that's gonna show you what the preview is gonna look like or the LUT's gonna look like on your camera. So off, on, and so after that, make sure, double check everything, make sure you're good there. We want to make sure 3D's checked, yep, and then we're just going to hit generate LUT. It's going to download, and for now I'll just leave that there, and I'll show you how to install that on your camera after I show you the download that Benjamin showed me. So here, you're going to look at false color LUTs. I'll also include a download in the description for standard profile and GH5 VLOG L. What's really helpful in post is actually putting a false color on top of everything and just double checking, make sure your exposure is the same in all your different shots. And so what this will give you a few different files. This is your standard profile of what it's, so with reds being blown out, purples being almost crushed. But this is going to be your VLOG, because your VLOG doesn't capture over that much. And so what you're going to get is 3 different LUTs, Cube, 3DL, VDL. VDL is going to be the one you're going to want to install on your GH5 as a monitoring LUT. The other you can install in whatever you use. I used Premiere Pro, so you can put that in as a LUT for your exposure in post. But you'll also get V1, V2, V3, V4, and all of these. I just have these two installed. This one's going to be just strictly color, and then obviously 50%. You're going to have a little less harsh of that false color on top of it. But go down, look at any tutorials. It's a great example. This will show you kind of what your underexposed image is. So your correct exposure and you're overexposed. But you just come here, click download. It's gonna take you to here. What's really nice is they let you pay whatever you want. I'm a big fan of try before you buy, so if you do like this, go back and pay for it, because someone put a lot of time and effort into it. And so I already have that downloaded, so I'll just go and show you how to put this on your camera. Okay, so I have my SD card right here. I'm currently just using the USB connection to it. Either one you can do. It doesn't really matter. And so this one right here is the one I just created using LUTCalc. And then these four are the false color download that I showed you earlier. This one is straight 100% opacity, and then this one's the 50% in the VLT folder. So basically all you need to do, drag and drop into your root directory. So this is the SD card. Just drag and drop straight into the top. What I like to do is rename it to where you know what you're doing in here. So it's a false color, 100, false color, 50. Just percentage wise. And so once you're done with that, you just eject. Wait for it to eject. Then I'm gonna show you on the camera via my iPhone. Okay, so now that we have our SD cards in with our LUTs saved in the root file, you want to go to your menu. Make sure you're in the correct profile, and it's going to be the second page with VLOG L View Assist. You're going to go to Read LUT File. Here we have our three files that we have placed on our card. And so you just want to select each one and save it to a set. So say the false color 100% opacity one. You just save it to which set. I already have these saved, so set one for my 100%. Make sure you hit yes. And then do the same for your other two, if you want to do two. And then the last one, save at set three. I don't have anything in set four right now, but I'm sure I will soon. So right now I'm setting VLOG 709. And so that's going to give us this view. And then if we go down to false color 100%, we now have false colors. And so with my cine lens, I can actually adjust the aperture very smoothly. And so as the image gets darker, we have those blues come up and the greens. And then we slowly fade to the reds, the yellow, and into the red where we're overexposed. I also have zebras turned on right now just to show me what I'm losing. So that's how I installed false colors on my GH5. Hopefully you learned how to. I'd recommend going and checking out LensProtoGo's YouTube channel if you don't know what false colors are. They have some great explanations and some tutorials on how to use false colors, whether it be while you're shooting or in post. If you have any questions, leave me a comment. I'll try to check those out and respond. But yeah, have a great day.